This illustration is about one block chasing the other on a rough incline. Here the figure shows two blocks A and B placed on a rough incline with the block A, given that it is root 2 meter behind block B. The coefficient of friction between plane and block A is 0.2 and that for block B is 0.3. We are required to find the time and location when both blocks will come on the same line. So, in the situation as both of these are sliding, that means here the angle of incline is greater than the angle of repose. So, here if we calculate the acceleration of block A, here we can directly write block A will be sliding due to mg sin theta and the friction acting on it will be mu n, that is mu mg cos theta. So, I can directly write the acceleration of block A as g sin theta minus mu a g cos theta. So, here the value of theta is 45, so sin theta cos theta will be root 2, 1 by root 2, and the value of mu a we are given as 0.2, so here we can write it g by root 2 multiplied by 1 minus mu a, so this will be 0.8 g by root 2, that's the sliding acceleration of block A. Similarly, we can write acceleration of block B as AB is equals to G sin theta minus mu BG cos theta. So, this can be written as G by root 2 multiplied by 1 minus mu B, and we are given the friction coefficient between block B and incline is 0.3. So, this is 0.7 G by root 2. Now we can see A is accelerating more compared to B, so finally it will catch B. So here we can calculate the relative acceleration of A with respect to B is, if we calculate it acceleration of A with respect to B, we can write as AA minus AB. So this will be 0.1 G by root 2, that is 1 by root 2 meter per second square. Here I have taken the value of g to be 10. So, if it takes t time to cover the distance root 2 meter with respect to block B, so we can directly calculate the time taken by A to cover root 2 meter with respect to B is, the time we can simply write as root 2 L upon acceleration of A with respect to B, as this distance will be half a t square. So, this will be root of twice of root 2 divided by 1 by root 2. So, that will be equals to 2 seconds, that will be one answer of the problem. And we are also required to find the location where both blocks will come on the same line, so that we can calculate the distance traveled by B in this time or in this duration is, this can be written as distance traveled by B is half acceleration of B multiplied by t square. So, this half multiplied by this 0.7 g by root 2, so that will be 7 by root 2 multiplied by 2 square. So, on simplifying, we are getting the value 7 root 2 meter. That is another answer to this problem. And this is the distance from the initial position of B where both the blocks will come on the same line.